हेलो गाइज, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल इंग्लिश अकेडमी। गाइज प्लीज़ लाइक शेयर फॉलो कमेंट एंड सब्सक्राइब द चैनल। गाइज इफ़ यू हैव सब्सक्राइब द चैनल नाउ वी कम ऑन द टॉपिक द पोइम ऑटमन। गाइज दिस पोइम वाज रिटन बाय द फेमस रोमांटिक पोइट जॉन कीट्स। जॉन कीट्स गाइज, बिफोर एक्सप्लेनिंग द पोएम वी मस्ट नो अबाउट ए लिटिल इंट्रोडक्शन एंड लिटरेरी कैरियर ऑफ द जॉन कीट्स। सो गाइज नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द पोइट जॉन कीट्स। गाइज जॉन कीट्स वॉज वन ऑफ द की फिगर्स इन द सेकेंड जनरेशन ऑफ द रोमांटिक मूवमेंट इन इंग्लिश लिटरेचर। गाइज जॉन कीट्स वॉज बोर्न इन द ईयर 1795 एंड डायड इन द ईयर 1821 एट द एज ऑफ 26 ईयर्स ओनली। गाइज कीट्स हैड अनटाइमली एंड इमेच्योर डेथ बिकॉज ही वॉज पेशेंट ऑफ ट्यूबरक्लोसिस। गाइज जॉन कीट्स डिडंट हैव फॉर्मड यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ एजुकेशन लाइक अदर रोमांटिक पोइट्स। ही टॉट हिमसेल्फ लेटिन एंड फ्रेंच। गाइज कीट्स डिडंट नो हाउ टू रीड एंड राइट ग्रीक, हाउएवर ही हैड मास्टरी ओवर द ग्रीक माइथोलॉजी। गाइज द टू ग्रेट एम्बिशन ऑफ कीट्स इन लाइफ वर टू बिकम एज ग्रेट ग्रेट ए सॉरी गाइज द टू ग्रेट एम्बिशन ऑफ कीट्स इन लाइफ वर टू बिकम एज ग्रेट ए पोइट एज शेक्सपियर एंड फुलफिलमेंट इन लव। गाइज कीट्स हैड टू एल्डर ब्रदर्स, वन ऑफ देम माइग्रेटेड टू अमरीका एंड रिटर्न फ्रॉम देयर। हिज अनदर ब्रदर वॉज ए विक्टिम टू ट्यूबरक्लोसिस एंड डाइड सून। गाइज कीट्स वॉज ए पेशेंट ओवर ट्यूबरक्लोसिस। ही नो दैट ही कुड डाई एनी टाइम, सो ही ऑलवेज हैड ए फियर ऑफ डेथ। गाइज द चीप कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स कीट्स अर्ली पोइम्स आर सेंसुअसनेस एंड पिक्टोरियल क्वालिटी। ही डिस्क्राइब्स नेचर थ्रू हिज सेंस इन ए पिक्टोरियल स्टाइल। इट इज़ बिकॉज ऑफ कीट्स क्वेस्ट फॉर एन एवर लास्टिंग प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ लाइफ दैट द पोइट्री ऑफ कीट्स एंड रीच्ड ऑन द फिलोसफिकल लेवल। गाइज द पोइट सेज दैट ब्यूटी इज ट्रूथ, ट्रूथ इज ब्यूटी। गाइज गाइज द पोइट आल्सो नोन एज एज द सुप्रीम लवर्स ऑफ गाइज द पोइट आल्सो नोन एज द सुप्रीम लवर ऑफ ब्यूटी एंड ही सेज दैट ए थिंग ऑफ ब्यूटी इज जॉय फॉर एवर। गाइज नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट पोएटिक वर्क्स ऑफ जॉन कीट्स। सो गाइज दे आर हाइपीरियन, ऑड ऑन ए ग्रीसियन अर्न, नेक्स्ट ला बेले डेम सेंस मर्सी, टू ऑटमन ऑन मेलनकली, ऑड टू साइके, लामिया ऑड टू ए नाइटिंगेल ऑन इंडोलेंस, एंड लास्ट ऑन फर्स्ट लुकिंग इन टू चैपमैन्स होमर। गाइज द पोइट आल्सो रोट सो मैनी पोइम्स विच आर मोस्टली बेस्ड ऑन द नेचर। सो गाइज वी डिस्कस अबाउट द पोइट जॉन कीट्स एंड हिज लिटरेरी कैरियर। नाउ वी विल कम वी कम ऑन द पोइम ऑड टू ऑटमन। गाइज ऑड टू ऑटमन इज वन ऑफ द फाइनेस्ट ऑड ऑफ जॉन कीट्स। टू ऑटमन इज द फाइनल वर्क इन ए ग्रुप ऑफ पोइम्स नोन एज कीट्स 1890। इट वॉज रिटन इन द ईयर 1819। हेयर द पोइट डिस्क्राइब द रिच ब्यूटी ऑफ ऑटमन सीजन, इट कलर्स एंड फ्रूट्स लाइक हिज अदर पोइम्स। गाइज बिफोर एक्सप्लेनिंग द पोइम वी मस्ट नो अबाउट द मीनिंग ऑफ ऑड। वॉट इज एन ऑड? गाइज एन ऑड इज ए पोइम दैट इज रिटन फॉर एन ओकेजन और एन on a particular subject, it is an elaborately structured poem praising or glorifying an event or individual, describing nature, etc. The English odd's most common rhyme scheme is ABAB, CD, CDE, CDE. Guys, Keats wrote to Ottman after enjoying a lovely Ottoman stay. He describes his experience in a letter to his friend Reynolds. Guys, you know that the first ode was written by the famous Greek poet Pindar. The Pindaric ode written in a regular stanza forms. After Thomas Gray, the English ode become irregular. Guys, now we will discuss the introduction and theme of the poem Ode to Ottoman. Guys, Ode to Ottoman is one of the simplest of Keats' odes. There is nothing confusing or complex in this ode. The season of Ottomans, with its fruitfulness, its flower, and the songs of its swallows gathering for migration. Guys, in this poem, the poet also describes the valuable aspects of life. He also emphasizes on morality, natural world, time, and transformations, etc., etc. So guys, first of all, we discuss about the man and the natural world in this poem. Ode to Ottoman contains very specific natural landscapes and images. The first stanza offers images of the interactions between human and the plants that surround them. The second stanza describes the production of agriculture, a natural process that is controlled by people. Guys, the third stanza moves outside of the human perspective to include things that are not used or consumed by humans. Guys, third stanza captures some of the wildness and unpredictability of nature. Guys, the poet also describes the most important value of the time. He also says, in this poem, he says that it isn't a coincidence that two Ottoman mention Ottoman and spring, but not winter. Guys, Keats doesn't want to dwell on the cold days to come. To appreciate Ottoman, we need to forget about how each passing day seems a little shorter and chiller. For the most part, the speaker's stays focused on the present moment. The nature world is at the peak of sunlight and ripeness in the first stanza, and by the third stanza, the sun is setting. Guys, in this poem, the poet also describes the forms of transformations. So guys, we will read it. Ottoman is in the time of transformation between the growth of summer and the dormancy of winter. Things are winding down, and once the harvest is complete, there is nothing left to do but wait until the next season. Much of the transformation in the poem occurs between stanzas. For example, in the first stanza, fruits and gourds are swelling outwards before they will be picked for food. By the second stanza, the harvest is already complete or mostly complete, and the ripe apples have been turned into rich, delicious cider. The third stanza focuses only on one transformative event, that the setting of the sun. Guys, in this poem, the poet also used the aspects of moral values. He says that Ottoman is frequently used as a symbol in the literature for old age. The time before death, symbolized by winter, to Ottoman avoids any super obvious references to death. बट वी डू गेट सम सबटल वंस लाइक द ओब्लिवियस बीज दैट थिंक द समर विल लास्ट फॉर एवर और द हुक दैट स्पेयर्स द पॉपी फ्लावर्स फ्रॉम देयर इन एविटेबल एंड एज द डे बिगिन टू डाई इन द फाइनल सेक्शन द एंटायर लैंडस्केप कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट्स टू द सॉन्ग्स ऑफ मॉर्निंग. So guys, I hope that you understand the theme of the poem Otto Ottoman. Now we will discuss about the summary of the poem. Come on guys, we will start now. Guys, Otto Ottoman. In this ode, Keats addressing Ottoman, describing its abundance and its intimacy with the sun, with whom Ottoman ripens fruits and causes the late flower to bloom. Guys, you know that the poem is divided into three stanzas. It gives a colorful description of the English Ottoman with all the beauty and richness of the season. While writing this poem, Keats appears to be in a mood of joy and contentment. The poem begins with a colorful description of the English Ottoman. Keats has presented Ottoman as a season of mists and ripened fruits. Ottoman is an intimate friend of the warm sun. Both of them work together for loading all the trees with fruits, all the fruits with ripeness. During the autumn seasons, the fruits get ripened. It is also season of the last flowers of the year. The bees have already filled their honey during the summer season. But when they find that there are more flowers, they started thinking that the warm days will never end. In fact, the autumn is the season of fruits and flowers in a great numbers. Guys, in the second stanza, the poet also describes that autumn has been personified as a winnower, a river, a gleaner, and a juice extractor. Autumn can be found working in the fields in different capacities. Whosoever tries to find out autumn, he may find him in the fields in different forms. The poet says that sometimes Ottoman seeds careless on the granary floor. Sometimes he can be found asleep while reaping the harvest. At other times, Ottoman can be seen crossing the stream with load of grain plants on his head. Finally, we may see Ottoman sitting by a sided place and watching the drops of juice coming out of the machines for hours. In the last stanza of the poem, the poet describes the song and singers of the Ottoman season. In the evening after the sunset, the songs of Ottoman seasons can be heard. The songs of spring are not there in the Ottoman seasons, yet Ottoman has its own music. The poet doesn't feel sorry for the absence of the sweet and melodious songs of spring. The poet says that the small bird sings in a more mournful tone, the groan of flames bleat for their enclosures, the hills. The cricket sings in the hedges, the red-breasted bird sings in a garden, the sailors twitters in the sky about. So guys, the poet says that, so we can say that Otto Ottoman is remarkable for its pictorial quality. It shows Keats a great painter in words. He has presented many words picture in this poem. The first stanza of the poem has the pictures of fruits, mists, and flowers of autumn season. Among the fruits, there are grapes, apples, groundnuts, and hazelnuts. In the secondary stanza of the poem, he has described the picture of the Ottoman in various forms and personifies Ottoman as a careless winnower, a tried reaper, and then as a gleaner and juice extractor. So guys, we can say that John Keats, as a great sensuousness poet, in the whole range of English poetry, William Wordsworth spiritualizes nature and Shelley intellectualizes nature. John Keats is context to describe nature through his senses. The beauty and color, the fragrance and sound in nature greatly appears to his senses. Guys, Otto Ottoman is an example of Keats' sensuousness at his best. In the poem, he has described the fruits, flowers, songs of Ottoman season through his senses. Guys, Otto Ottoman is remarkable for its artist excellence. It shows almost all the qualities of Keats as a poetic artist. It is remarkable for its pictorial quality, economic of expressions, just of beauty, great spirit, classical restraints, and emotional intensity. The poet doesn't have all romantic strongness or mystery. Everything here simple, direct. In this poem, the poet doesn't have any romantic strongness or mystery. Everything in this poem are simple, direct. We find a mood of tranquility throughout the poem. The living personification of Ottoman, one in the style of the ancient Greek poets. Guys, now we will discuss about the language and style of the poem. Guys, Otto Ottoman is a beautiful nature poem. Here we have close observation of nature. It shows Keats' simple and deep love for nature and its beauty. Like the other odes of Keats, it doesn't have elements of melancholy. The poem is divided into three stanzas of 11 lines each. The first stanza has a pictorial description of fruits and flowers of the Ottoman season. Guys, the second stanza of the poem has various personification of Ottoman. And the third stanza presents the beautiful pictures of birds and insects. Guys, the poem was written in a simple and direct language. The style of the poem is description as well as pictorial. Guys, the choice of words is perfectly appropriate. And the poem is also remarkable for its musical quality. The rhyme scheme differs from stanza to stanza. In the first stanza of the poem, the rhyme scheme is ABABCDCDEEE. The scheme of the second stanza is ABABCDECDDE. Similarly, the third stanza has a rhyme scheme ABABCDECDD. Guys, it appears as if Keats fully enjoys the Ottoman season and he feels no regret for the spring that is gone. Thanks so much, guys, for watching the video.